Hello again, students. So in this video here, I'd like to continue with an introduction to the class, but less so about my philosophy and some of the structural elements of the class. In particular, just right here early on, let's just take a taste of Astronomy 101 and just to get your mind thinking about the sky and some concepts that'll come up in the class later on. So first of all, in this image right here, I have four pictures of the sky. The first one right here sort of shows the sun against a nice blue sky. It looks like a very nice day. Here's the same sun over here, but it's setting. And then we have some nice blue sky here, but there's a rainbow in it. Rainbows are fun to see. And then here's some storm clouds coming in. The sky starts to look kind of gray. And so some of the questions that you might ask as an astronomer here is, why is it that over here the sun looks so white? And of course, there's always the outstanding question about why is the sky blue? So we see that in there. But then why is it over here when the sun is setting, it takes on this reddish look? Because it's the same sun and the same sky, and all right, maybe there's a little bit of blue sky up here, but it looks very reddish in this area right here, but nothing but white to be seen up in here. And then when we go over to the rainbow then, if you sort of look at the rainbow like this here, this sort of represents all colors, doesn't it? Because you see the reds, the yellows, the greens, and the purples all the way down, so we sort of see all colors. So same sky, all these pictures here, same sun, but some very different color effects going on, which we'll have to talk about. And here, of course, when the storm clouds are coming in, things start to look kind of gray, so we'll talk about that as well. On the topic of sunsets, I do have an assignment for you, which is called the Sunset Selfie. And make sure you see Canvas for all details on this thing. It's just a small assignment worth about 5 points. So you're definitely going to want to check this out. And what I'd like you to do is, of course, take a photo of yourself with the sunset in the background. That's the nature of the sunset selfie. Number two, when you take that photo here, note the time and date that you take it. And the most important thing here, as far as this class goes, is using the compass on your phone, get the exact direction that the sun is setting in, because we sort of have this idea in our minds, is that does the sun always set in the west? Is that like a hard, fast rule about when things set? So write the direction down, and you can just write something just right off the compass from your phone, whether it's the number in degrees or the directions. But get all that submitted, and bottom line, check Canvas for full details. It's always interesting to ask introductory students, how do you pronounce this word? And what I'd like you to do then is go on Canvas, and for about your first 5 points of credit in this class here, there's an assignment that I'd like you to tell me how you pronounce this word. And it's not just tell me by typing something in. I'd like you to actually make a sound recording and record your voice to see and upload and tell me how you pronounce this word. Canvas has a built-in recorder you can try to use. You can record some other way, but get a sound file uploaded. And if you have trouble with Canvas, if you use Chrome, a sound recorder will be built right in for you. But go ahead and give it a try. 5 points of credit on Canvas. How do you pronounce this? This is a planet. And I wonder if you could possibly give me the name of this planet. Anyone? Mm-hmm. These look like some sort of white sphere that has some different fractions of it illuminated. I wonder if you could think or tell me what this is. Yeah? And I think everyone knows what this is here. This is, of course, our moon, and I love our moon for a variety of reasons. It's just beautiful to look at, particularly when it's a nice full moon. And there's two or three things that are sort of mysterious about the moon that we'll have to talk about here. In particular, number one here, what are all these dark splotches about? You see them all over the moon, here and here and here and all over the place, dark splotches like that. And number two, why are there these white areas of the moon? And maybe number three if you want, what are these things right here? All these little holes and pockmarks and things like that all over the moon. I wonder what those are. And the other question that we might wonder about this, is it possible to sort of know or see where we humans have landed on the moon? Bunch of stuff to talk about with the moon. We'll get there. And I wonder if you could wonder what this is right here. You ever seen this before? It's a planet? Big piece of rock? What is it? Well, turns out that's actually the back of the moon here. So whenever we're living on Earth here, we always see the front face of the moon. This might hopefully looks familiar to you here. But all this is over here, this is just the back side of the moon. And it's just kind of a little bit of a mystery here, a question mark in there. It's like, why do we never see this side of the moon? We always see this one right here, but we never see that one right there. Is it something about our vision or clouds or something about the moon that we can never see the back? In fact, it really wasn't even long ago before humans saw the moon for the first time. It's something like in the 1960s or so was the very first time that the backside of the moon was ever seen at all. So there's definitely something to talk about why we always seem to see the front of the moon. So there's something about the moon and this picture right here, but I'll pick it up in the next video.